We're constantly hearing from health officials, don't touch your face with unclean hands. Luckily now, there's an app for that.
When you go to touch your face, it gives a little vibrate. So right now it's not vibrating because my hand isn't right near my face, but now it is. It's vibrating, it's vibrating, it's vibrating, it's vibrating, and now it's not vibrating again. So it's just a little reminder not to touch your face.
It's called the Jalepeno app made for Fitbits.
We called the app Jalepeno because there's a meme going around that you should act as if your hands are covered in jalapeno juice and that will stop you touching your face. I thought it was a funny little idea, and then I built it and found that it actually worked, so I figured I should release it.
What started as a funny little idea is now a helping hand during the ongoing coronavirus outbreak.
We've been told to do three things, to reduce social contact, to wash our hands, and to not touch our face. And if my app can help with one of those three, then it's all for the good.
Dr. Binston is using her experience as a tech design professor to do her part during the pandemic. She hopes this app will not only help people stay clean, but also serve as a message to her students.
I think it is maybe it's a good example that when you see a problem, that there are sometimes simple ways of addressing it. I wish I could think of an app that would help you wash your hands.
Besides setting a good example, she's also helping those already affected by COVID-19. It costs 99 cents to download the app on your Fitbit, but proceeds will go to the Hawaii Food Bank.
It's going to be a tough time in Hawaii and around the world. People are going to be on reduced hours. People are going to be out of work. Small businesses are going to be really badly impacted. So I think we all need to do what we can and use our skills to help out however we can.
Dr. Binston is also working on Apple Watch and Android versions of the app. Reporting from Honolulu, Christy Tomashiro, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.